Hello friends, my name is Vijay Kumar and we are studying refrigeration and air conditioning. In the last video, we have seen the evaporator. We have seen the concept of evaporator and then classification of evaporator. In that, I have covered the one by one all the evaporators. Now, in this video, we will study about the expansion devices. This is a part one video. In this video, we will see the capillary tube and automatic expansion valve. Let's start the topic. Expansion devices. An expansion devices is another basic component of refrigeration system, like evaporator, condenser, and compressor. Expansion device is also an basic component of refrigeration system. The basic function of an expansion device used in refrigeration system are to reduce pressure from condenser pressure to evaporator pressure. Basically, it reduces the pressure from condenser pressure to evaporator pressure and regulate the refrigerant flow from the high pressure liquid line into the evaporator at a rate equal to evaporation rate. That means it is controlling the flow also at equal to the evaporation rate in the evaporator. The expansion devices used in refrigeration system can be divided into fixed opening type and variable opening type. In fixed opening type, the flow area remains fixed. The expansion devices used in refrigeration system can be divided into fixed opening type and variable opening type. In fixed opening type, the flow area remains fixed. That means constant area. The expansion devices used in refrigeration system can be divided into fixed opening type and variable opening type. In fixed opening type, the flow area remains fixed. The example for fixed opening type is capillary tube. Second, variable opening type. In variable opening type, the flow area changes with changing mass flow rate. Okay, now the example of variable opening types are constant pressure or automatic expansion valve and constant superheat or thermostatic expansion valve, what we call TEV. Third, float type expansion valve. There are two types of float expansion valve, like high side float valve and low side float valve. These two are based on the location of float type expansion valve in the refrigeration system. Let's see capillary tube. The capillary tube is an important part of refrigerator. Capillary tube is having a very smaller diameter. Diameter is very small of a capillary tube and bigger length compared to the other copper piping of refrigerator. Capillary has very small diameter and very long length, bigger length. Typically, the diameter of refrigerant capillary tubes range from 0.5 mm to 3 mm. Range of diameter is 0.5 mm to 3 mm and range of length is 1 meter to 6 meter. Now, refrigerant is in high pressure state, that means at condenser pressure. When it enters the capillary tube, it is the device which reduces the pressure of refrigerant up to evaporator pressure. That means the capillary tube is reducing the pressure from condenser pressure to evaporator pressure. It is not an expansion device. Remember, it is not an expansion device. Though it can sometimes be termed as expansion devices, but it is not actually a expansion devices. Actually, it is a throttling devices, because for capillary tube, I have already told that there is a isenthalpic process. So it is a throttling device in which enthalpy is constant. In throttling device, where pressure drop occurs due to friction effect, and pressure is reducing, why? Because of friction effect. When a refrigerant mixture passes through a tube or pipe, there is always a pressure drop. You know the equation HF is equal to FLV square divided by 2GD. Based on this, you can easily see that this is the pressure loss or head loss that is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to diameter of a pipe. If diameter is very, very less, then head loss will be more. If length is more, then head loss will be more. So, two To increase the friction losses, the capillary diameter is very small and length is kept bigger. You can refer the equation of pressure drop, which is a function of diameter and length. Thus, capillary tube is nothing but a device where pressure reduces due to friction effect, and this is the value of friction. And because of throttling, cooling occurs. Okay. Now, capillary tube made of copper and is most commonly used. Capillary tube is made up of copper material. Capillary tubing is used for small refrigerating and air conditioning system like household refrigerators, water coolers, deep freezers, window air conditioner, and split air conditioners. You have to remember here the word capillary is a misnomer, since the surface tension, you know very well that surface tension is related to capillary effect, and here the surface tension has no relation with the refrigeration system or refrigeration application. So here the capillary is just a misnomer word. Okay. So friends, we have seen the capillary tube. Let's see the constant pressure or an automatic expansion valve, what we call AXV also. This is called AXV also, automatic expansion valve. In automatic expansion valve, this is the arrangement of valve. This is the strainer and this is the input to the expansion valve. That means refrigerant is coming from this side, and through the strainer refrigerant will go, and it will go to the evaporator like this. Refrigerant will flow like this. Strainer will remove the foreign particles and dust particles also. And this one is the needle and seat, valve seat, you can say needle and valve seat. This arrangement is completely valve. This is the diaphragm, and this one is a spring, and this is the adjusting screw. We will adjust the spring pressure with the help of this adjusting screw. Okay, let's see. The constant pressure expansion valve keeps the pressure inside the evaporator constant, no matter what the load inside the evaporator is. That means it is maintaining only constant pressure, whether load is high or low. Okay. So hence the name is given as AEV or AXV. It does not allow the control of flow of refrigerant through it, even when lesser or more refrigerant is required in the evaporator. That means it does not allow the control of flow of refrigerant. Because the prime requirement for the AEV is to maintain the constant pressure in the evaporator. So it does not control the flow of refrigerant in the evaporator. Okay. The constant pressure valve is also called as automatic expansion valve. Why? Because in earlier days, the hand expansion valve was used, hand operated. Now, after that, this was produced, that constant pressure valve, and this was not operated with the hand, so the name was given automatic expansion valve. But in the name of automatic expansion valve, there is nothing that is controlling automatic. This automatic word here is a misnomer. You have to remember this thing. Okay, now see friend, this is the normal position of expansion valve. In this expansion valve, if I say this is the normal position and refrigerant is flowing like this only, so what will be the effect if load is increasing in the evaporator and load is decreasing in the evaporator? Let's see. Before study that thing, see here. Now the evaporator is connected here like this. If evaporator is connected like this, and it will go into the compressor. So whatever is the pressure of evaporator, that pressure will be upward to the diaphragm. So PE is the evaporative pressure or pressure in the evaporator. The direction of evaporative pressure will be upward to the diaphragm. And second pressure is PS. This is the adjusting screw. For adjusting screw, I have adjusted the screw, and with that adjusting, the pressure is created. That pressure is PS, pressure in the spring. Okay. For normal position of expansion valve, this PS will be equal to PE. For normal position, of expansion wall, PS will be equal to PE. You have to remember this thing. And this is the normal position. Flow is occurring through this wall. Flow is occurring through this wall. Okay. Now let's see the effect. Effect on this. Effect of load variation. Let's see the effect of load variation. If load is increased, what will happen? If load is increased in the evaporator, you have seen that in evaporator at constant temperature or at constant pressure, heat is absorbed from the storage space. That means if load is increased, that means in a room, if heat load is more, heating is more, then evaporator has to take more heat. That is the meaning of heat, more heat load. So in evaporator, if heat load is increased, so pressure in the evaporator will also increase. If pressure will also increase, that means PE will increase. At equilibrium condition, PS is equal to PE, but at increase in load, PE will increase and PS is less. So PE is greater than PS. Pressure in evaporator will be greater than pressure in spring. In that case, this diaphragm will move upward. In that case, this diaphragm will move upward because of movement towards the because of upward movement of diaphragm, this wall will close. If wall will close, then less amount of refrigerant will flow. This is not desirable. This is opposite of the requirement. If load is high in the evaporator, then more amount of refrigerant should flow through the evaporator. But here valve is closing, so less amount of refrigerant is flowing. Less amount of refrigerant is flowing into the evaporator. So it is not desirable. This is opposite of the requirement. Okay. Now, second case, if decrease in load in evaporator, if load is decreased, that means heating load is less. In that case, the pressure of evaporator of refrigerant, the pressure of refrigerant in evaporator will reduce. If this will reduce, and in that case, the pressure of spring will be more, so diaphragm will move downward. Diaphragm will move downward. Because of downward movement of diaphragm, this valve will move downward. So valve will open in this case. If valve will open in this case, then the refrigerant, more refrigerant will flow to the evaporator. That means more refrigerant will enter to the evaporator. So this is also not desired because heat load is less. So in that case, I want the less amount of refrigerant, but here more amount of refrigerant is flowing to the evaporator. So this condition is also not desirable. Okay. Now in case of increased load, there is a starving of the evaporator. Starving, that means evaporator requires more refrigerant, but because of closing of this valve, less refrigerant is flowing to the evaporator. So this is the condition for starving of evaporator. That means bhookha. Okay. Bhookha, ise bhook lag rahi hai, but ise kam khana mil raha hai. Okay. Now, decrease in load. That means flooding of evaporator. In this case, requirement is less. But isko jo refrigerant ja raha hai, it is more. More refrigerant is flowing to the evaporator. So this is the condition of flooding of evaporator. Because of these conditions, if load increase or load decrease, this AXV automatic expansion valve will not work at any cost. That's why this AXV will work at constant pressure. At constant pressure means PS is equal to PE only, it will work. Okay, let's see. Hence, it should only be used on system with a fairly constant heat load, not a varying heat load. Because it does not control the amount of superheat at the outlet of the evaporator. Here, the meaning is that in thermal expansion valve, we will see that thing. In thermal expansion valve, there is a control on superheat. Control on superheat. Based on that superheat, refrigerant will flow. But here, there is no superheat and there is no amount of refrigerant flow. No control on refrigerant flow. So it will work only constant heat load. It does not work well on the system with dramatic changes in heat load. I have already explained. In fact, the dramatic change in heat load caused a problem with the system. I have already explained. You see once again here. During the starving of evaporator, less amount of refrigerant will flow through to the evaporator. So less amount will flow into the compressor. Then in compressor also there will be a problem that it will take less amount. So at less capacity compressor will work. The chances of damaging of compressor will be more. And in this case, flooding, more amount of refrigerant is flowing into the evaporator. So compressor will also take more amount of refrigerant, more liquid it will take. So this will also damage the compressor also. Because of that, it is written that this causes the problem in the system. Some point about AXV you have to remember. The automatic expansion valve are used for milk chilling unit and water cooler where freezing is disastrous. Automatic expansion valve are simple in design and are economical. These are also used in home freezers and small commercial refrigeration system where hermetic compressors are used. We will see hermetic compressor, what is this hermetic compressor when I'll teach the compressor part. Normally, the usage is limited to the system of less than 10 TR capacity. AXV is used where 10 TR capacity refrigeration system is there. So friends, in this video, we have seen about the capillary tube and automatic expansion valve. In details, we have studied all these things. In the next part of this video, we will see the thermal expansion valve and float side valve. Thanks for watching this video and have a good day.